I'm Pat Gunn, and this is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4. So we're going to continue the theme of doing a bunch of miscellaneous quests, but today we're going to start with going after Zeller. Now, the people of the people of Bunker Hill. They've charged us with putting an end to a particularly nasty set of raiders that have captured and tortured a whole bunch of their civilians. And that's what we're going to do. Partly this is so that we can open up trading posts in our settlements, and that once we do this, we can just build them and settlers will show up. I'm sorry, not settlers. Traders will show up wherever we build them, which is kind of handy. Because even though we can now build top-tier trade posts, it's kind of nice to be connected into the existing network of traders, because there are some supplies that if we build them, they're quite handy.
I hear someone. Combat positions.
So this is the hideout of that gang, and you can see they have a pretty creepy place. And you can also hear that they have watches, which is pretty smart of them. This is a pretty decent place, but they are not using it intelligently enough. Ideally, you'd want to have like a guard tower up there, keeping an eye on that entrance. There's only a few entrances to this building. So we can see they're running around back there. They do know that we're here. And I have crappy aim. But not irredeemably crappy. Just not particularly amazing. Okay, so keep moving forward.
Show your face! Come on, I dare ya!
Kind of a pit area. And yeah, they do have a good number of people hanging out here, but they're not particularly smart with how they're going about it. And it is. I have some pretty good stealth on me here.
Only a fucking coward
okay.
Eye.
I'll give you that one. Ah!
Yeah. So it's going pretty well. See, down there is a raider. And once he.
What the? Oh, I know you're here.
Yeah.
I'll find you.
It's going pretty well. Now, we saw a chain door down there. This is the other side of that. And we're going to hop on down. So, apparently, what that guy, or what the raiders do, they come in here, lock the door, and it looks like they do bad things to settlers. So, we're putting them out of business. Now, you'll notice that most of the raiders that you kill here have a blood contract, because this is not a typical raider gang where it's just disreputable people ganging together. Here they seem to have a viciousness that's trained because they're more of a cult than a standard raider gang.
Like a grenade went off in here.
Kinda. And so apparently they kidnap ordinary citizens and raiders and then put them through some psychological torture until they signed something called a blood contract.
Fuck.
And I think to make good on the blood contract, they then actually have to do some pretty horrific things.
Fuck.
Damn. There's some pretty good loot here. But the place is also kind of full of traps, so you have to be careful.
Really bad.
It helps to have a silenced weapon, as I do. Oh, it tucks. Always kind of a fun thing to put your settlers in. Actually, Well, except Hancock, he has his own theming, and it almost seems a shame to want to take him out of it. But he also looks amazing in a tux. I think I'll leave him in his outfit. Yeah, we started going up, but now we're going to clear out the ground floor. Now, you can go up here, but you can't really go anywhere from there. And there's another chain store. And no way to really progress further in this direction from the ground floor. That's fine. Because I believe that the way that you get there, just like before, is to drop down from above. More of those blood contracts.
Then please let's stay put. Otherwise, let's find some cover.
I think they're the ones who need some cover. But, yeah, we'll keep moving.
Right for the taking.
Okay. Mini nukes are always good to have. Yeah, I believe that there are a few traps here. Yep, a gift for him. It's kind of hilarious how Bethesda snuck in a book collecting game into Fallout. Not that it's particularly useful to keep gathering the library books, but you can get some small prizes, and it's amusing. Okay, let's keep moving. I believe that we're right above those rooms that were locked. Okay, unfortunately we've just made...
Get back, Tony!
Don't you die on me!
Big mistake!
It's the run!
Now, one of the areas where the game is really annoying and silly at the same time is that there is an incredibly strong difference. That enemies have to go after you rather than your companion.
Now you better be watching.
It's probably the right thing game-wise, but it makes absolutely no sense. Just because otherwise you can just always hang back and let your companions take care of everything.
Where'd the little bitch go?
And there's one of the traps that I mentioned. I think there's a few more. Yep, there's another mine. Now, fortunately, I have my sneaking skill at a level where
no sign of them now.
I don't need to worry too much about those because I don't trigger them. My companions can, though, so I have to be a little careful, but not nearly as careful as if I could trigger them. Okay, yep, that's good ammo. Let's keep moving. I was sure that somewhere up here there was a way to drop down into those rooms, but I'm not going to spend too much time worrying about finding it. Okay, and on we go.
You killed him!
not need to worry too much about being seen until I'm right on top of somebody.
Got it. Hey there.
Don't let any of these Zeller's army bastards live.
You should probably just get out of here. Okay, and you can see... Yep, so there's a bunch of captured merchants here, who Zeller is probably going to try and turn into members of his gang through his psychological torture.
Nice. Hi.
Kessler send you? Thank God.
Okay, now you're free to go. That's a pretty
good one. Yes. Hey there.
I couldn't take much more of it. Thank you.
To be kind of corrupted into a state where one loses one's humanity. It's easy to pretend that that would never happen.
Seen blast craters in better shape than this place.
But I think it's actually kind of... Oh, that is interesting. Definitely have a glitch. But I think people often overestimate their resilience when they're thinking about situations that they've never been in before. Okay, so... I'll take a quick nap. Even though Zeller is just over there. It's kind of a dumb thing to do.
This ain't exactly scenic.
To get rid of that. Okay. And here we are at our foe. Well.
This is bullshit.
See if we can start it off with...
Do it again! Here is his kingdom, there is his chair. And he has been dethroned.
You think these were part of the original design?
And the present steamer trunk. So yeah, that's the end of his gang, and we have completed this quest. Didn't take too long. It's kind of amusing. Not sure if I've ever been out this door before. Yeah, continuation of the building, and it would be probably nearly impossible, if not actually impossible, to hop up here, unless you had a jetpack, which might let you do it.
Remember, we've got no bots in the list for tomorrow.
Okay, so there's that. We were asked by somebody to eliminate a threat at the Vault-Tec office. I'm not quite sure where that is.
Absolutely no funny.
Well, it's near the mess, state house, but I think that's overrun by mutants, so we're going to approach from a nearby safe travel point that we know is relatively safe. Okay.
You know.
So we want to go more.
Now, when the hell are they going to turn that thing off?
we're almost there. The door should be, I guess, it's probably this building. And this seems to be a functioning door. So let's pop in and see what we can find. I don't quite remember who gave us this quest. Might be a railroad thing. Might be something else. Oops. Oh, goodness. And we start off with the steamer trunk. Well, I would guess that that means that this was not the door that they really expected us to enter from.
Watch it.
But again, Fallout is pretty good. Even if Fallout 4 is a little bit less good, and letting you play the game multiple different ways. Ooh, a legendary. Interesting. But one shot. And bye-bye. Oh, okay, this was given to us by a caretaker at caretaker at the railroad settlement that we built. So let's quickly remind ourselves, is it hooked up to our trade network? No. So we can go do that. Coastal Cottage, I believe, is what we want. So we'll pop back into the Mechanist's Lair and build a trade bot for there. And by our naming convention, that will be Tradebot Mech Coast. Cottage. And we can drop off some other stuff. Don't need that. Nor that. Nor that. Nor that. Yeah, at some point I'll probably come back and sell a lot of this stuff. But.
Hey!
So he has a gamma gun that he doesn't need and a whole lot of gun. Gamma guns, they're kind of a fun
one. Currently, in fact,
but
unit
not
room.
Not a particularly practical one. It's mainly there's the issue of their ammo being pretty shoddy.
Meaning, in fact.
So off we go to travel to the coastal cottage to tell the caretaker there that we've cleared out that area. Hey-doo.
You weren't there at the switchboard? One day, the insect suit's gonna kill us all, I tell you.
Already taken care of. I hardly even broke a sweat.
Whatever you did worked. The tourists...
Mm-hmm.
Take this.
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, forced impacts, that's kind of nice. And a little bit of XP. Cool. So we still have that settlement. It's not particularly great. But next, let's go and talk to Kessler. And this will open up the trading post. Now, there are a few settlements that you have that that will be visited by certain traders. But it's only certain traders. What this will do is open it up to, I think, the four regular traders that you can find wandering around the wasteland.
Someone put in a whole lot of effort to keep out the riffraff. And yet, here we are.
One of the prisoners told me what they went through at the prep school.
I don't want to be around when
I had no idea. And you did that by yourself, right? Here's the payout.
Glad it turned out well.
I'm happy you're on our side.
Okay.
With your help, the roads are... Heard you got land of your own. Tell you what, build a safe place. Uh-huh. But either way.
Okay, so she won't join up with you? Like, you can ask her, I believe, and ask her if she's willing to join your...
For a change, someone I actually want to see. The Hill owes you. Raiders will think twice about the double cross, after what you did at the prep school.
Maybe not. Okay. I might be misremembering. I was under the impression that... So let's turn those off. And we're going to go and search the Automatoys factory for parts. Let's do it. This has always been one of my favorite little quests, and it doesn't take too long. It is true that that there is a Meyer Lurking in the spot. I thought that that might have been fixed, but it's not. I don't think that we've put any people here yet. We probably should. Although, frankly, this is one of the areas that needs the most work, because it's barely a place. Like, you have a car, you have a really completely ruined house, and then you have a completely ruined shack, and that's a settlement. I've sometimes turned this into a pretty nice settlement that I'm proud of, but just the resources that you need to spend to do that, it's not a small deal. You're basically, you have almost empty land with some inconvenient things that you can't scrap. And that's your starting point. But then, if you were to take most cities in the U.S., or actually most cities anywhere, and imagine clearing them out from all land, you would probably find it pretty intimidating. How much work is involved in turning them into a place, turning them into a home. What we have here is some crabs. But this is a super mutant. house, or stronghold. You can kind of tell by the presence of these kinds of things, the giant bats. Now, you could just try and go at this straight, or you could attempt to instigate a fight.
Do you see? I am such a bucket in for show up. I'll rip his leg clean off.
Yeah, so you can try and instigate a fight between nearby raiders and the super mutants, or you can just go at it yourself.
Time to die!
Today, we're just going to go at it ourselves. See that this definitely was a place where
sooner or later
where Giddy-Up Buttercups were made in large numbers. And what we were asked to retrieve is the spare parts for these things.
I can smell you out there, little sneak! No more hiding for you!
And here we're definitely happy that... we put someone Shepherd into upgrading our rifle. Because it means that we're careful and intelligent, we can make sure we're...
There you are!
You hear something?
I think you'd have to be kind of deaf.
There you are!
If you had strong, you could pick up some more armor that you might want to put onto him. But usually by the time I'm here, it's fairly late game, and I already had and finished up with strong. A whole bunch of bags of cement here, which
I find to be a pretty useful thing to have, so I usually make sure I get them, which unfortunately might mean walking a little bit slowly. Oh yeah, did we gain a level? Yeah, we gained a level. So for this, let's just take our medic skills the rest of the way up to being outside. Okay, so now we heal super quick with medic. Hey, dude.
Hey.
Check the stash.
And we can give him all of that really heavy cement. And the minigun. And a lot of the other heavy stuff. Okay, so we are lightweight again. And while we're here, just because it's pretty handy to have, we're gonna fill up.
Hey!
Shoot!
Grab that!
On all the spare metal that we can get, courtesy Hancock.
Get that!
Good as done.
Pick that up!
Sure.
Take that!
You got it.
Grab that!
Bingo.
Heads up!
What do you need?
Get that!
Sure.
Come on. Do it, dude.
Pick that up.
I can do that.
Take that.
Bingo.
Grab that.
Good as done.
Get that.
You got it.
Pick that up.
Sure.
Yeah, so as noted, your companions, although you can't trade it to them.
Take that.
If you just directly tell them to pick stuff up, their weight limit is ignored.
Grab that.
Good as done.
Get that.
Bingo.
Pick that up.
You got it.
Grab anything useful.
I can do that.
Take that.
Sure.
Grab that.
You got it.
So I think that all of this would have either put me or him or both over our weight limits.
Get that.
Good as done.
Grab anything useful.
Bingo.
Check it out.
Sure.
See if there's anything there.
Bingo.
Take anything good.
Good as done.
Pick that up.
You got it.
Take that.
I can do that.
Yep. So if you just keep doing it, then
grab that.
You end up with a pretty full collection of all this stuff.
Get that.
I can do that.
Come on, Hancock.
Pick that up.
You got it. Can't do it.
Over here. Move here.
Good as done.
Take that. Grab that.
Sure.
Get that.
Bingo.
Pick that up.
Come on, dude.
Take that.
You got it.
Grab that.
A few other tricks that you can do, that some of which feel a little bit like cheating.
Get that.
Good as done.
Pick that up.
I can do that.
Take that.
Good as done.
Grab that.
I can do that.
Get that.
You got it.
But yeah, this is just another way to, if you care about building settlements,
bingo.
This is just another way to get advantage.
Grab anything useful.
Sure. You do what you gotta.
Take that.
Bingo.
Come on, dude.
Grab that.
You got it.
Get that.
Good as done.
Oh, this is game. I think I might be at the point where I can just grab everything remaining. Maybe. Hopefully. And plus, I don't need to get all of this.
Okay, so I think we're done here. Which is fun, so let's head back to the Murkwater construction site to drop off a lot of this stuff.
Heads up.
This is what I've got on me.
Junk, including the minigun and all that other fun stuff. So our weight is back to reasonable. Largely. And yeah, once we have this hooked up to our trade network, we'll have a lot of good stuff. Video. Well, actually, if we're going to return to Arling Glass, I think what we're going to do is a optional and hidden part of this. Somewhere around here, I think, was the Vault-Tec ruins. Might have even been there before. Sorry, not Vault-Tec. We want the Wilson Automatoys corporate headquarters. Because that's where Arlen used to work. He was the principal architect, I believe, for these toys.
What's that?
And so if we can go in here, we can find... Whoa. I think we've hit a framework issue, or frame rate issue.
Could use a...
I'm not sure why this happens. It just seems to happen every so often. Let's see if we can navigate the door. And, oh, yep, framework. But yeah, 2 frames per second is just unreasonable. Okay, back up to 60 while we're reloading. Let's see. 60. And everything's smooth again. Yeah, so I'm not sure what happened there.
Oh, I'm feral now.
Okay, master door to unlock. Let's use it.
Sweet.
One thing we've learned is that generally unlocking a master door is a pretty good sign that you're skipping some plot points. That's okay. Let's see what's in here.
I don't see it. You?
Yeah, it's kind of a fun computery area.
Getting hungry.
Now, if you want, you can just hang out with the super mutants and
no
let them
green
talk.
Stuff here.
And they have some pretty good, interesting dialogue. Apparently, they're obsessed with finding the material that transforms
so
humans
boring.
Into super mutants.
I'm hungry.
I hear human, stringy, bony,
or tasty. Better than Brahmin or bugs.
Anything's better than bugs. You're right, brother. Not.
You know, someone, somewhere, would pay real good money for that ugly thing.
What? Who's there?
And so we're going to see what we can do with this panel, because it has some wires coming out of it. G-R-O-O-M-E-D. This is plausible.
Sweet.
Ah, there are some turrets, and we can turn them on. Unfortunately,
come out,
killed our friend.
Well, we're gonna
fix this. Hold on. Okay, we're back.
Get after
him. I've restarted the game.
Use all
that to fix the frame rate issues. Really annoying during the state where that is how we have to do things. But you deal with some
things.
You know yourself pretty well, sister.
Okay, so we're gonna keep going. We have a makeshift stairway. Not sure whether it's meant that somebody yanked that down or it collapsed and people just chose what stuff to clear when they were trying to turn this into a fort. Also unclear, I guess in 200 years, whether this has been a consistently
nice try
facility or whether it's been used by other
targets.
Or whether it's been used by human settlers as well. Anyhow, we have the key. The reminder.
Jeez, looks like these.
We have notes about Arlen Glass.
Folks got to skip the war.
The Commonwealth is ours!
And this was Arlen Glass's lab. It might have actually been since Arlen Glass's times. Use reminders to himself to do certain stuff. And there's mention of servos, so there's a decent chance that these things originally could move. So we're going to eject the tape and open the safe. See if we can get some more layers.
Where'd you go? Huh? I'm gonna find you. I'm gonna kill you.
He would keep a pistol in here, but apparently he did. It seems to be pretty common.
Sooner or later. Gone now! Pity.
And there is an overlord, which is one of the stronger mutants. The Primus is stronger. But they're up there.
I can hear you.
Do what you gotta.
Again, if you have strong with you, then you can get some good armor for him.
It was nothing.
And all sorts of adhesive. Is, as I mentioned, probably far too many times before. I believe that elevator takes you down to the basement.
Ugh, some places you just wish they'd nuked harder.
That is funny. And you can take a full-size Giddy-Up Buttercup, which I think they're kind of cool. Maybe a little creepy, but pretty cool. And so that's what we want. Then that means that we're done here. So we will just head downstairs and slip out the door. frame rate issue, which is pretty great. And let's head back to Arlen Glass and tell him what we found. We found a tape from his wife, and we found the parts from the factory. Or maybe it was a tape with his little girl. I think it's a tape with his wife. But in either case, we've gone beyond the call of duty to get him some stuff with great sentimental value. The thing with wolves is that apart from not being particularly healthy looking, they...
I need this!
Been around
Excuse
forever.
Me.
You're bad. Were you able to find those parts?
I've got them right here.
You do? Yes. You've more than her. Now I need to...
Hey.
What is it?
I think I have something that belongs to you.
Holotape? Let's see now.
Go ahead. Hi, Daddy.
Oh, wife and daughter.
When are you coming home?
Oh, God.
Now you've worked too much. I want you to read to me again. Mommy says you're helping all the horses find a good home. Take care of them, okay?
I
love you.
And?
Oh, Buttercup says she loves you too. We miss you. Come home soon.
That's gotta be a pretty heavy one.
Give me a minute. It's been so long. I never thought I'd hear their voices again.
It's a long story.
And maybe she was right, you know. I did all I have as one parent to him.
All these years.
I suppose we made toys. And as long as I...
What now?
Here. And one more thing. Please.
Okay, well, you've done a good deed. I don't know if it really is likely to make him happy.
No.
You can hear that he's playing it again. Which is charming. It's kind of sad that... Like, just the weight of living that long. It's gotta be rough. At the same time, life goes on.
When you...
And sometimes people end up surviving things that take their family, even if, in this case, it's just time. There have been various historical events where...
Strong getting hungry.
Families
want someone to eat.
I'm gonna take the Giddy Up Buttercup toy and drop it off in my, well, what I'm coming to think of as my, well, it's kind of, it's under junk. So we have two of these guys, and we'll just drop both of them, the big one and the small one. Whoop. Maybe I'll drop it on the bed. I'm not quite sure where it went, but maybe it fell through. Nope, well, it's somewhere up in there, and I'm happy about that. It'll turn up somewhere. I'll figure out a way to get it out from wherever it's fallen. But now for everything else, we'll just drop it off. And finally, we're going to go and, I think we'll leave special delivery for another video, and I don't think we really have too much left to do in this one. Special delivery, I believe, will be the next thing that we do. And we might do part of a model citizen, I'm not really sure. But yeah, this feels like definitely a good break-in point.
So, that'll be all for now.
No green stuff here.
And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.